Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15.3 Beta 2 and iOS 15.2.1 have been out for a few days. Both of them released on the exact same day, which is pretty rare, and I'm running iOS 15.3 Beta 2 on my 13 Pro Max and 15.2.1 on the 12 Pro Max. Now, I've been using these myself, but also wanted to share your experience based off the YouTube community poll, where we have over 10,000 votes and 259 comments. I've taken my experience and combined them with all of the information that you've left in the comments to give you a better idea of the overall stability of both of these updates, as well as any remaining bugs, issues, and whether or not you should install this update based on that and battery life and more. Now with iOS 14, it looks like we'll no longer have that option to upgrade to newer versions of it. If you are on iOS 14 or earlier versions, you could go to your settings, then general, then software update, and Apple would give you the option to update to iOS 14.8.1 from an earlier version. You no longer have that option since iOS 15.2. And according to 9to5 Mac, it looks like we're not going to get this option any longer. So Apple did say that they would provide security updates and more so you could stay on previous versions, but it looks like they're no longer doing that and instead backtracked on that. And they're pushing iOS 15 updates and probably working on iOS 16. So maybe they just don't have the amount of workers to get that updated regularly. So either way, it's no longer a thing, and that's a bit unfortunate. Now, also with iPhone 13 devices, many people have been messaging me, and we've been talking about the issue with the option for noise cancellation when on a phone call. The option just isn't there. So if you go into your settings, and then you go under accessibility, so we'll go back here on the 13 Pro Max, under accessibility, then you go down to where it says audio/visual. On the 12 Pro Max and any other device recently, you have phone noise cancellation. You don't have that on the 13 series devices. And Apple supposedly was going to add this with a software update, but now it looks like based off support documents and a few different articles out there that they've just said they're not going to update it altogether, and it's not a feature of the iPhone 13. Now, whether or not they just have implemented something else and not given us the option, or maybe there was a parts supply issue or something else, we're not going to have the option on the newer phones for some reason. So prior to this, it says noise cancellation reduces ambient noise on phone calls when you are holding the receiver to your ear. So you had the option to turn that on or off. That's no longer an option, sadly. So apparently this isn't going to be fixed. We've talked about it a bit in the past, and it's something that they've apparently aren't going to fix, or maybe they are and the article's wrong, but it looks like it's not going to be something we're going to get. Now, as far as overall stability of iOS 15.2.1, for most people, it seems to be pretty good. Most people are seeing this. However, there are quite a few people who are saying that you have random freezing and lockups. So whether or not you're scrolling through an app, you go into music, or you go into a different app, it would lock up and freeze. And that could be on older devices as well. And most people that have that issue, if you reboot, it fixes that issue. So there is an issue with that. What's causing it, we don't really know, but it seems to be an issue for a lot of people. But again, it's resolved just by rebooting. Also, CarPlay seems to be fixed for most people, but it seems to be very dependent on what car you're using. So I had someone message me that has a Ford, and they said it's working fine in the comments there. They said it's working fine. Google Maps is working again for most people with the touch input, but some people are still experiencing issues. So I'd be curious to know what car you have if it's not working, whether it's a Honda or a Toyota or a BMW or something along those lines with CarPlay and what the experience is, because they do have to sort of control that and implement it. So it could be some cross compatibility issues. Performance wise though, most people are saying that 15.2.1 is working just fine. There really isn't any issues. And here's an iPhone 10, which seems to be working fine with it as well. No real issues. It's smooth and in general, pretty good. And for battery life, people are experiencing decent battery life, but it's only been a few days, so sometimes that can improve. Initially, you'll have pretty poor battery life, and you can see here's from a user, Cameron, that sent this in. He had 7 hours and 58 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 53 minutes of screen off time, and used about 80% of his battery, or 75% of his battery. That means if he kept using this, he might get 10 or 11 hours of screen on time. So it's not amazing, but it's okay. If we go back another day, you'll see the day after the update came out, it was a little bit worse. So it will progress and get better as the days go on. But again, it should improve. It really shouldn't be much different than 15.2. And most people are saying it's the same. Cellular connectivity is fine for most people. It's basically going to be the same as 15.2, as I didn't see any modem updates, but the beta did have modem updates. Again, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are saying that it's good. And one person did say they're having network issues, but they didn't specify what version they're on or what device they're using or anything else. So I'm not exactly sure what's happening there, but there are some people saying that. But there are a couple bugs people are having, and that has to do with notifications, reminders, and alarms. I've had some people say they've missed alarms altogether. Also, people saying that notifications when they come in are not making any noise. And other people are saying that maybe their reminders are not reminding them. So there's some odd issue with that. Now, whether or not they have Do Not Disturb turned on with a focus mode that would affect that is hard to say, but they are saying that they have those issues. So there are still some bugs in 15.2.1. So 15.3 seems to be much better for most people. And performance-wise, 15.3 seems to be pretty flawless. It's super smooth when scrolling, no issues on ProMotion or anything like that. And I've been pretty happy with it so far. So when you're scrolling, this is the app library. It seems to be nice and smooth, no issues there. And performance in general is pretty good. So there hasn't been any complaints with performance on it. And cellular connectivity is fixed for me compared to the previous version. So with the previous version, I had issues switching between 5G and 5G UC and then back to LTE and Wi-Fi. It's fine now. It's actually working just like it should, finally. So it's working much better on the latest version. Now, something that's affecting all the devices is the storage bug. Most people are saying that they're seeing odd storage bugs still. We know about this at this point, where the iPhone storage either doesn't load at all, it shows the wrong amount of storage, or it's just using excessive amounts of storage. Right now, it's looking okay for me, but if I go to the bottom, sometimes the storage for system data just never loads. So there are some odd bugs here. Why this hasn't been ironed out, I'm not sure, but it's not really a priority in the sense that it's affecting the usability of the phone. So maybe they're working on that a little bit later and trying to get more important things like cellular connectivity to work properly first. Also, there's that music bug. This is something I'm a bit surprised that they haven't fixed yet. When you're streaming your favorite song or whatever you're listening to and it's not downloaded, it can use a ton of battery. It ramps up the CPU and then in turn uses battery. However, I haven't noticed too much of that with this beta, and the phone hasn't gotten warm, meaning that the CPU is being used quite a bit. So it's been nice and cool for both of these versions, and I wouldn't really be too concerned as it stays nice and cool for most. The majority of people say the same thing. So most people are having a very good experience on 15.3 beta 2, with the exception of maybe battery life. Battery is okay, and I'll share with you my battery life and then someone else's. So if we go to battery, my battery health is at 100% at this time. And the last 10 days, yesterday I had 2 hours and 10 minutes of screen on time, 12 hours and 4 minutes of screen off time, and I was playing music throughout the night with headphones in. The next day, or today, 2 hours and 6 minutes, 6 hours and 17 minutes of screen off time, and I haven't even used a quarter of the battery yet. So it really depends on the day. Again, the day after the update was pretty good. 3 hours and 42 minutes of screen on time, 8 hours and 37 minutes of screen off time, and I used about 30% of the battery. That's what I would expect from this device. So it's really hit or miss. It seems to vary greatly depending on the day. It doesn't make a lot of sense, but it seems to be a little bit better. On the iPad, it also seems to be better. So on the iPad, I've been using my 12.9-inch iPad Pro, and if we go to battery life here, battery does seem to be improved this time around. Not great, but over the past few days, I've noticed that I've charged it less. So I charged it on Friday to 100%, and I've used it a couple hours, and I'm down to 63%. Now, the one thing I'm not sure about is the screen off time. It keeps showing 12 hours and 5 minutes of screen off time. I wasn't using anything with the screen off, so I'm not sure what that's about, and there's definitely something still being used in the background. However, I noticed that I have to charge it less in the last 3 days. Everything else about iPadOS has been super smooth and no issues, though, so that's a good sign. I think 15.3 will iron out a lot of those bugs, whether it's on your iPhone 11 or your iPhone 10 or any of those devices. It seems to be much, much better. So 15.3 seems to be where it's going to be much better for most people. Abhishek sent in his battery life from an 11 Pro Max on beta 3 as well, and he's having a similar experience. So you'll see today or yesterday. He had 5 hours and 7 minutes of screen on time, 24 minutes of screen off time, and used about 50% of his battery. So that's pretty good. The day before, he used a little bit more than 50%, but only had 4 hours and 52 minutes. So about 10 hours of screen on time, which is pretty good for a beta. So it looks like it's doing well for him. Now, as far as when to expect the next version of iOS 15.3, well, based on what we had last year, I would expect a release candidate this coming week or beta 3. Apple last year released a release candidate and then a final version after only two betas before the end of the month. So this coming week on Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday, well, if they're going to do what they did this past week, I would expect it on Wednesday. Maybe we'll see beta 3 or a release candidate, but I think it's going to be closer to a release candidate. Maybe not, though, as they are planning to release that digital ID, Apple Digital ID, in select airports around the United States and start testing that. And they said they'd do that in February. I mentioned that in the What's New video. And so I expect something along those lines pretty soon. So maybe before the end of the year we'll have, or the end of the month rather, we'll have that. And then maybe a release in early February. It's going to be either at the end or early February, I think, at this point. And then we'll move on to iOS 15.4 betas. And then, of course, June is what I'm looking forward to most, where we have WWDC, and then Apple shows off iOS 16 and whatever's new in that. There's some rumors saying that it's going to have some big redesigns. I really hope so, but it's a little bit too early to tell. Now, as far as whether or not you should install iOS 15.2.1, I would say absolutely at this point, since it's basically the same as 15.2 with a couple bug fixes and security updates. However, as far as 15.3 beta 2, if you have a beta device already, then definitely update to it. However, if you're on the public version, I typically don't recommend installing maybe a beta to your device unless you have a backup and a computer that you can roll back if you have any issues. So typically it's stable enough, it seems, to use, but just be cautioned that there can be problems. And as long as you don't mind submitting feedback and giving Apple feedback on bugs that you can expect, I would probably stay off of that version for now until maybe the release candidate. Now, as far as the YouTube community poll and comments, let's take a look at some of the comments. But at the time of this video, let me refresh here. There's been over 10,000 votes, and you can see 65% of you are already on iOS 15.2.1. 11% of you are on the beta, 15.3 beta 2. 13% of you haven't updated at all since 15.2 or older. 3% of you are using iOS 14.8.1, and 8% are using Android. So again, thanks to everyone that voted and commented. So let's take a look at some of the comments, maybe 5 or 10 of them. Benjamin says, I'm using iOS 15.2.1 on an iPhone 13 Pro Max. I'm still having touch issues when charging my phone. Basically, it is impossible to use the phone while charging. That sounds like something else going on, whether it be a screen protector you're using. Nothing with charging should affect that. So I would maybe try a different screen protector if you're using that, or just try a different charging adapter. I haven't ever heard of that issue before, so definitely try something different, though, as that's not a common issue. It's the first time I've heard of it. Alpha Bravo says, iOS 15.2.1 on my iPhone 7 Plus. Battery life is pretty much the same as on 15.1. CarPlay still doesn't work, and I've noticed that my reminders that I've set aren't going off. Come on, Apple, what happened to the reliability of iOS? Will says 15.2.1 seems better on my iPhone 12 Pro Max with battery, initially getting 8 hours compared to 6.5 with 15.2. But it's early days, 15.2 got worse with time. Matt said beta 2, amazing in everything except the battery life. The connectivity is the best it's been since iOS 14. Just Dave said, I've had 15.3 beta 2 on my iPhone 13 Pro Max since release. The bug I had where my iPhone would respring when haptic pressing to clear notifications seemed to be fixed so far. I live in Canada and turned private relay back on. I have yet to receive a notification. It is not supported as I did on beta 1. Hopefully the issue has been resolved. The Roblox Doge HQ says, I've been using iOS 15.2.1 on my iPhone 11 and it seems to be relatively the same as iOS 15.2 in terms of battery life, performance, and stability. Mark B said, I'm using the latest 12.9 iPad Pro with iPadOS 15.2.1. Everything seems fine, but my iPad keeps overheating and I need to turn it off for 30 minutes. 15.2.1 on my iPhone 11 Pro Max is fine besides the battery drain. First of all, you can't really overheat the device. It's actually going to regulate itself. It may get hot, but if it's hot to the point where you can't touch it, then it might be too hot. Otherwise, it might just be from you playing a game that's processor intensive. So I really wouldn't worry about that. Maybe try a hard reboot, but typically it's going to get warm either if you're fast charging it or maybe playing an intensive game. iOS 15.2.1 app library search keyboard doesn't show up immediately. I've noticed some odd bugs in previous versions where you would go to the app library and tap to sort of search and it would just go back to the home screen. So it looks like they've had a few odd issues with it from time to time, but it does seem to be a little bit better, and at least it's popping up now. Lorenzo said, iOS 15.2.1 has been a very interesting update for me. I'm using the iPhone 11 64 gigabyte model. I've been having issues with the storage bug that constantly notifies me that my storage is full, which it isn't. The Freestyle Libre 2 application is broken and won't read the sensor, which I use for my type 2 diabetes. That's an important note, and hopefully they update that app very soon for those of you that use it. Also, most apps crashed and had to re-sign into after updating to 15.2.1. Battery life is much better than 15.2, though. So again, this is an interesting thing that if you're using that app for your diabetes to measure blood sugar, I would be careful updating as it seems to have not worked, although they could have already updated the app. Vincenzo says, I got a bug on iOS 15.2.1. When I ask Siri how much battery is in my AirPods 2, she responds with two symbols of percent sign. I mean, she says 50%. Cameron says, using iPhone 13 Pro Max on 15.2.1, today battery seems to be great so far. It's smoother and seems snappier than 15.2 for me. Thank you for the amazing content. Thank you. Hayden says, I'm on iOS 15.2.1 on my iPhone 12. It's running great for me. Shivraj Roy says, much better than 15.2 on iPhone 7. And so that's everything with iOS 15.3, Beta 2, and 15.2.1. I'm looking forward to that release candidate or final version of iOS 15.3, where I think they'll fix a lot of issues. And of course, iOS 16 should add quite a few new features. I hope they're going to come out with a new control panel and more, but we'll have to wait and see. It's only a few months away. Time's flying, so hopefully we'll see that in a few months and maybe some new products before then. Let me know what you're most excited for in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description below. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.